Hey guys, Photoshop Pro Help here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to whiten your teeth. So really brighten them up and make them the shade that you want them to be. So as we can see with this image here, it has lovely teeth but they are a little bit yellow. So we do want to brighten them up and make them a lot whiter. And we can do this with a few easy and simple adjustment layers. So all we're going to do is we're just going to go and zoom in. So let's zoom in on the image, and we want to make a good selection of the teeth and nothing else. So there is a few ways you can do this. You can use the quick selection tool or the pen tool. I use the pen tool because I like to do this all manually and get everything that we need selected. So I'm just going to go and show you with the quick selection tool. So we can go and grab that on the left hand side, and we're just going to go and select the teeth. As you see, it's selecting them really well, and you can really bring the tolerance down and select little bits if you need to. But I'm not going to go too in depth with this because that's more about selection techniques. If you don't know about that, you can jump over to my other video and learn about selection. So once we have done that and we have made the selection, depending if you have used the quick selection tool or the pen tool, so if we have used the quick selection tool, what we're going to do is we're going to feather this. So we're going to go up to select, we're going to go to modify, and we're going to go and feather, and we want to feather the radius by 3. Now if you have used the pen tool to select everything, let me just deselect. Just going to go around and show you. So we're going to go and make selection, and all you're going to do is feather the radius by 3 pixels in this as well. So that's the two different types, quick selection and the pen tool. So once we have got our selection, just going to delete that, there we go. And I've already made my selection a fairly good selection. So we're going to go down to the bottom right hand side now, and we're going to go to the adjustment layers. And that's the little symbol that's a round circle with black and white. So go and click that. And we're going to go up to hue and saturation. And all we're going to do is play around with the saturation and the lightness. So on the saturation, we're going to go for around about minus 57. And as you can see, it's really brightened the teeth up at the moment. We're going to go to minus 2 on the lightness. And that's brought them to a more realistic shade. But with this, you can play around because each image is totally different. You don't have to go by my guidelines. So really play around and see what shade suits your image. So once you have got the shade, we're just going to go and hide that. And we're going to go and use the levels now. So we're going to go and make the selection again, and you can do this by holding control on your keyboard or command if you have a Mac and making that selection. So clicking the hue and saturation layer we just did. So we're going to go back down to the adjustment layers, and we're going to go up to levels, and all we're going to do now is add some shadows that we lost while we was playing around with the hue and saturation. So we're going to go and play around with the middle slider, and I'm just going to go and bring this up, and I'm going to bring this to around about 0.90. that best suits this image. And we're just going to go and notch the little white slider on the right up a bit, and as you can see, they do turn different shades. Now, as I said, play around with it, get the shade that you want. We don't want to go too bright because we don't want to make him into Simon Cowell. So we're just going to go very lightly to around about there. So we're not bringing the shade up too much. So we're just going to go and hide that. And that's basically it. You're all done. How easy and simple was that? You can apply this into any photo that you need to. I will say that this best works on high definition images. If you have a low definition image, you might have a little bit more work on selecting the teeth. depending on how your photo turns out. So if I zoom out now, just to show you, and I'm going to go and take off the effect just to show you what it looked like. So there we go, there's the original, and there is after. As you can see, considerable amount difference, and they are a lot whiter. Now you can change the shade as you want, as I said, because there is all adjustment layers, so there is nothing harming the actual original picture. So going to have fun with this. Please comment, rate and subscribe. Go check out the website, guys, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. See you for now.